Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and I thought I'd add some super fast storage to my new 2019 Mac Pro. And OWC has been providing high quality products for Macs and PCs for quite some time, and this uses four m.2 NVMe SSDs in order to get the highest performance over the PCIe bus. So these come in with 1 terabyte of storage, 2 terabytes, 4 that we have here, and up to 8. And if you go all the way up to 8 terabytes of storage, you're going to spend about $2,000. This one is about $1,000, and it goes down from there, but this is super fast storage. So let's go ahead and open it up and take a look at it. Now it's supposed to come with a license for SoftRaid. So let's open this up. You'll see it's just a little guide that comes with it, and it should be ready to go. Just pop it in the Mac Pro and we should be good. So let's take this out of here. It's actually pretty heavy. And you'll see it says Accelsior 4M2. I'll flip it over. There's the bottom, and it just slots into your PCIe slot in the Mac Pro. On the end, there's nothing really here, but we do have these cooling vents or a heat sink on top. Let's take this off and see what's underneath. Now there's 5 screws total. Let me go ahead and remove them. Now let's go ahead and remove the heat sink off the board carefully. And there we go. Now you can see the four M.2 NVMe drives. And what this does is uses all 4 of them at the same time to get the fastest speed using what's called RAID 0. Now you can configure it differently. You can configure it to use 1 drive to boot and use the other 3 as redundant storage, however you'd like. But I'm going to use this for video editing, and it'll be using all of them at the same time. Now some people may say this could be unreliable, but Apple actually uses this themselves. They'll use RAID 0 on the Mac Pro to combine 2 terabyte drives into 1 4-terabyte drive and speed everything up. And it's been pretty reliable. I've never had one fail. I'm sure someone has, but I'm going to use it for video editing. And this has a 5-year warranty as well. Now, each one of these can use the full 4X bandwidth that we have available, and that's because this has a built-in PCIe switch. So this should be the fastest way to get the most out of each one of these drives. Now let's take a look at the heat sink here. You can see we have our thermal pad underneath, and then there's a thermal pad left behind here. But let me go ahead and put this back on, and then I'll install it into the Mac Pro and we'll take a look at it. Now we'll open up the Mac Pro by turning the handle and lifting the cover straight up. And once we have this off, now we have access to our PCIe slot. So I'll start by removing the actual cover that secures it. It's just held on with 2 thumb screws. And once I have that off, now there's this clever switch. We just click this over, it unlocks the PCIe cards, and then we remove the PCIe slot dust protection covers. And this isn't stamped aluminum, it's actually milled, so it's really nice. So let's go ahead and slot in the Accelsior 4M2. We'll just push it into the PCIe slot there, click it into place, then we'll lock them down again with our switch. Now we can lock in the PCIe card with the 2 thumb screws, and that's really all there is to installing this, so it's really simple and easy. And here's the back of the Mac Pro with the card installed, just so you get an idea of what it looks like, even though you'll never see it. Now I booted up the computer and the drive is ready to go. Now I'm not going to use it as a time machine backup. Now the drive is configured by default, and all you have to do is go into your Finder and you'll see it there. It has SoftRaid already on the drive, so you can just install this right away. I've already installed it, so let's take a look at what we can do with the drive. We'll configure it the way I want for video editing, and then we'll do some speed tests. Now I have SoftRaid open, and I've initialized these or erased them so that I can configure them how I want for video editing. You'll see the first 4 here are the drives themselves, and they're 960 gigabytes each, or basically 1 terabyte. The controller is the last one. So I'll click on the first, hold shift, click the last, and then I'll right click or option click, and then click new volume. Now on this, I'm going to name the volume. I'll name it FCPX Scratch. Since I'm going to use it as my scratch disk for Final Cut Pro, it will be what I edit everything off of. And here we can set it up as RAID 0, RAID 1, 1 plus 0, 4 or 5. I'm going to use 0, and I know this may not be the most reliable over time, but I've never had one fail, like I said before. So we can set it up as HFS plus, I'll use that. And then we'll optimize it for digital video so that we can use it for video editing. And then we'll click create. And then we'll click OK. It's creating it. And now it's going to ask me, do I want to use it as a backup disk? And I don't. So I'll click don't use. And now the drive's ready to go. So I'll go ahead and close SoftRaid and let's see how fast this drive actually is. Now the standard drive built into the Mac Pro is on the left and the new OWC drive is on the right. So I've got a Final Cut Pro library here. I'm going to copy this to this drive. So let's go ahead and do that. And I'm copying it in real time. It's about 20 gigabytes and it's done. So that gives you an idea of how fast it is. Maybe I'll copy these YouTube videos as well. There's a bunch of compressed videos in there. And it's about 50 gigabytes or 58 gigabytes. And you'll see there's 10 seconds or so left. So this is incredibly fast. So we'll just wait for it to complete and then we'll run some disk speed tests. So we'll give it just a second here. And now we've copied a total of about 70 gigabytes in under 40 seconds or so. So that's unbelievably fast. Let's go ahead and take a look at what it's capable of. Now using Blackmagic disk speed test, we can see the actual speed of the drive. So we'll select the target drive and then we'll go down to our FCPX scratch disk and click open. Now we can change the stress that we put on the drive and I'll select 1 gigabyte just initially so that we can see the actual speeds once we hit start. So we'll click start and let it run for just a moment. And you can see the write speeds are about 4,828, give or take a few, and 5,438 for the read speed. This is incredibly fast. Now I'll select 5 gigabytes and put the drive under more stress and let it run for a little while so we can see how it performs when it heats up. The drive performed pretty well. You'll see it did dip down to about 830 megabytes per second at times, but as it cooled down, it just went right back up. So over time it performs well and I've been using it to edit video on and have had no problems whatsoever. So it seems like it can handle the high data transfer rates over time with no problem. Now I'm in the system report and you can see all of the different drives on the computer. So here are the 4 different drives on the computer, on the PCIe card. And if we click on one, you'll see that we have a link width of x4. And that x4 means that it's running at full speed because it has that PCIe switch or the onboard controller that can handle the speed. So it will run full speed no matter which card you're accessing, whether or not you're using it as a boot drive or whether or not it's in RAID 0 or however you're using it. Now we'll take a look at one other benchmarking tool. And this is actually a new app called Sensei that gives a nice visual representation of what's going on. So we'll click run benchmark. We'll browse for our FCPX scratch disk here and click open and then let it run. And it's a little bit slower than the speeds we were seeing with Blackmagic, but it's close enough that it's incredibly fast. So you'll see it's 3,600 read speed, about 3,800 write speed. So this looks like a very nice solution for your Mac Pro if you want to fill up those PCIe slots and get some extra storage that's just super fast. And thanks to OWC for sending this along for review. They didn't pay for this video, but they did send it so I could check it out. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.